The family of a security guard attacked with a meat cleaver are tonight demanding answers after one of the accused teenagers was granted bail. The 17-year-old was freed yesterday despite a lengthy criminal record, which Nine News can exclusively reveal.
This 62-year-old cleaner is hard at work at a Mount Warren Park laundromat when she spots three teens loitering outside. She goes to check out what they're doing. Then this. She's aggressively pulled through the door. Police say the teens then threatened her with a knife and punched her in the face before stealing her car with her dog still inside.
It has been a horrendously difficult time.
Thankfully, the thieves drop her dog off two streets away, but their alleged crime spree didn't end there. Hours later, the same group is accused of attacking 57-year-old security guard Johnny Fenaroa with a meat cleaver at the Westfield Helensvale. All were quickly arrested. But one of the accused, a 17-year-old boy, has since been granted bail by Magistrate Janice Crawford, and now he's back on our streets.
It is frustrating. It's frustrating for the police and for the community. One of the biggest challenges is about bail, you know, for police. And how do we better make sure that those that shouldn't be on bail aren't on bail?
We can't name him or show his face, but we can reveal that in the month of August, he's racked up a plethora of charges of offences, including attempted murder, armed robbery, two car thefts and break-ins. This cleaner is stoic, telling Nine News off camera that she refuses to be labelled as a victim and says that she won't let these kids win and that she's already returned back to work. And this from Johnny Fenaroa's family. They've expressed their extreme disappointment that the Southport magistrate saw fit to grant bail to the 17-year-old involved in the Helensvale security guard incident.
They are real Queenslanders with real stories, and that's where the government's focus should be. And right now it's not.
There needs to be consequences for young people who do the wrong thing.
Peter Fegan, Nine News.